So Dallas, thanks so much for joining. Are you coming in from where? Dallas?
I'm in Dallas, Texas. Dallas and Dallas today.
Nice, nice. Well, maybe you can just start by giving people, you know, your background and obviously your role at Invitation Homes.
Yeah, you know, but almost 10 years ago, my partners and I started a company called Invitation Homes. Today, we're the nation's largest single family rental provider with over 80,000 homes across 16 markets. And so our business primarily consists of, you know, acquisitions, buying homes, fitting them to our standards, fit and finish wise, and also creating a resident experience that we hope over time and distance becomes really second to none. We call it, you know, the leasing lifestyle. We want to create an environment where people live easy. And, you know, being here today with you and Lucas is an important part of that story in terms of how we view our homes and how we make sure they're safe and secure. And I think, you know, most importantly, what does that in aggregate provide to our customers as part of that overall experience? We want our customers to stay with us for a long time. And, you know, tools like SmartRent are things that we provide in our homes that make that experience that much better.
And I'm curious just how the first interaction went, obviously, between Invitation Homes and SmartRent. Maybe you can tell that side of the story from the Invitation Home side, and Lucas, you can tell it from the SmartRent side.
Sure. So, you know, we've been active in the smart home technology space prior to getting to know Lucas better. And Lucas obviously had a history with even some people at our company. So that made it seamless. I think where Lucas brought, you know, really good insight was around what maybe an SFR multifamily operator would need real time. And that's not just hardware, but it's services. And I think as you look at what's out there today across, you know, call it the spectrum of what you can acquire or invest in, you know, being nimble, keeping your fixed costs on a subscription side at a relatively low basis, but also having a hardware that can integrate and update seamlessly is really important. And, you know, our business is a perfect example of the fact that we don't turn very quickly, right? With 80,000 homes, but so you need both software and hardware that can integrate easily and that can also update itself over time.
Yeah, one of the things that was really exciting for us, Brendan, and I'll let Dallas give his view on this too, is just, you know, at SmartRent, we are obsessed with the customer experience, the resident experience, and really making that elegant and seamless experience. And what we found in Invitation Homes was a partner that was as focused, if not even more focused on that. And I think together we've pushed each other to even be better. And that really, you know, I got my start in single family rentals and Dallas started Invitation Homes 10 years ago, that we had to make a better playbook. We couldn't kind of draft off of what we'd done in multifamily for a long time. And what's exciting is we are sort of these pioneers in this field. And now we've come and taken all the learnings and all the best practices and we're bringing it to the entire rental industry.
And I guess, you know, when you first adopted it, Dallas, it seems like what's so interesting about SmartRent is that there's so many different kind of like ways that can be attractive. Obviously, grow top line, you know, reduce costs, reduce complexity, you know, potentially even like retain tenants longer and like reduce churn. How did you start to see some of those proof points?
Yeah, I mean, retaining your customer as long as you can is obviously paramount in any occupancy-driven business. And so if you think about our business today, we've got residents that are staying with us, you know, 3 years plus. And so what can you add to that experience that makes that more of a sticky factor for deciding between maybe home ownership or for lease product? And I think, you know, today, smart technology is in the earliest of innings in terms of where it's going. We care a lot, not only about the resident having this great experience where things are seamless, but think about what it does in terms of drag on our own costs. You know, when we lease a home today, 50% of the time we're leasing that home before it's ever unoccupied, right? And so that's a really interesting factor. So then as a home becomes vacant, what are the seamless ways that we can create ingress and egress points for potential customers going in and out of our home without having to have our people on site, right, per se? And it all funnels into this technology stack. And so SmartRent is, I would say, a gateway in terms of where that experience is going. I think, you know, in today's world, call it 2021, it's a nice to have, but over the next 5 years, it's going to be absolute need to have. It'll be commonplace that people aren't unlocking their front doors with physical keys, right? I think everything's going to go digital. I think the way that you can start to add resources and things to a smart stack in a home will make us very efficient and tell us a lot more about our homes, whether it's the thermostat that we already employ with Lucas and his company today, or whether it's, you know, the hub actually evolving and telling you more things around appliances and software readings on some of those appliances will help you do things in a more efficient manner. The ESG part of this story will continue to evolve as well. You know, how environmentally friendly are your homes? We're using the SmartRent stack today in some of our markets and piloting with major utility companies, just in terms of how you think about driving best practice and efficiency around cooling a home. And those are, you know, innovative. It's early innings in terms of where it's going to go, but you know, someone's got to start to figure some of this stuff out. And so having a partner that can create both the hardware and the software that allow operators like us to do what we do only creates a better value proposition for our customer, allows them to stay longer, makes our returns better, you know, and it's a winning proposition for everybody. So we're pretty excited about what Lucas and his team are building right now.
And Lucas, how was it for you, obviously, expanding into kind of the single family rental space? Obviously, it's kind of like taking a multifamily asset and turning it on its side and obviously increasing some complexity. But was that a relatively seamless rollout for you?
Yeah, I mean, the differences of time and space between units are an incredible challenge. And that's that, you know, that's why I think the single family rental business took so long to become institutionalized, is we needed, you know, cloud and mobile technology to catch up. But for us to pivot, you know, our background is in single family rentals. And so for us to pivot back to that was very easy. And it was kind of a great feather in our cap to get back and have Invitation Homes come on the platform. You know, they are the leading operator. They're the biggest and the best. And we love having them be a partner of ours.
And so Dallas, as a, you know, tech forward, you know, real estate owner operator, what excites you about just participating in this merger transaction?
Well, look, it's exciting. I mean, for a lot of reasons. One is validation, right? I mean, we've invested with SmartRent and are excited to, you know, have another bite at the apple, so to speak. And it's an exciting time for them. I think visibility on companies like this happens in some ways better in a public space, right? Because the scrutiny and the ability to kind of understand where the growth profile of the business is going is one that requires a lot of reps and a good management team. I've learned that personally through taking Invitation Homes into the public space, and their degree of, you know, execution is measured. And rightfully so. I think as a shareholder, you like that transparency. I also think, you know, hopefully for Lucas and his team, a successful offering will also allow cheaper cost of capital going forward. It'll give you the ability, you know, to invest in new technologies and also put you on the radar, right, for other businesses that may not even be aware of the suite of services you guys provide. So I think I view it all as an absolute net positive. I think it's a successful story, Brendan, for you guys and your brand as well, right? I mean, identifying early companies that have, you know, huge upside to them, both from an investment thesis perspective, but also execution. I mean, it's one thing to have a great idea, but it's another thing to really execute. And it takes, you know, a few of these kind of excellent parts together to create a successful story. So we're just excited to be along the ride. Lucas and his team have been a great partner. We're excited to grow with them. We're excited to be an investor in the business, and we want to find ways to really enhance and also validate each other's theses around where single family rental and where kind of the smart home aspect of this business is going to go.
Awesome. Well, Dallas, your perspective is always so valuable and really exciting that, you know, we're all a part of this amazing transaction. So thanks, Dallas.
Thank you, guys.